Hi, I'm Bob Ward from Microsoft. I'm here today to show you a demonstration of how Columnstore indexes can help you achieve better performance in scenarios where you have users running direct type queries from tools like Power BI. In front of me, I have a Power BI report I've built based on a database stored on SQL Server on Linux based on TPCH, a TPCH workload, which is an analytic query type workload. So I took the TPCH database schema, which you can see some of the tables over here from that schema, built about a 30-gig type database on SQL Server on Linux, and built this Power BI report on top of it. And one of the reports I built was kind of a canned visualization report of something I call shipping priority, which kind of shows where in the world are shipments being delayed that could cause loss of revenue for a business. And the larger the circles, the more important it is to focus on that part of the world on shipping priority. So this TPCH database is running SQL Server. There's no special Columnstore indexes on it, running your standard index, clustered index technology. So I can take a shipping priority data set here and refresh it. And this allows me to refresh this visualization. And you see it's pretty quick. And notice here in the bottom right-hand corner that the size, total size of the data in the database is around 16 gigabytes. Now what I've got up here is a command shell script using our popular tool called OStress to simulate multiple users all trying to refresh the same data, much like you'd have like multiple Power BI users going directly against SQL Server. So let me kick this off, and I'm trying to do that same refresh I did earlier. So if I hit refresh data, you're going to notice now that this is going to take some time. This is a little bit frustrating. So one user is great against this direct SQL Server query, right? But multiple users all at once are going to get frustrated because they're all trying to scan massive amounts of data in the server, potentially overcommitting memory resources and even overcommitting CPU resources. Let me stop that workload for a second and then show you another scenario that you're probably used to with Power BI users. So Power BI is such a great tool for drag and drop visualizations. So I'm going to take data from my customer table called market segment, drop it in here, and go into the line item table, which is a very large table, and take quantity. So I'm trying to see what is the quantity of order items in my inventory by market segment. So I'm going to drop it in here, and you're going to notice right away with this little circle spinning that there's a delay in result set processing. And again, this is because a very massive scan against a very large table in this database is taking place. Now the results come back. But if you don't like this table format as a Power BI user, you may want one of the other visualizations. So I'm just going to click on some of these, like a bar chart or a pie chart, and you'll notice here, the delay. And that's because every time I click on a visualization in direct query mode against SQL Server, it's having to rescan the data to try to redraw that visualization. That could be a somewhat frustrating experience to a user doing Power BI. So what I've also done is built another database identical to that, using Columnstore indexes. So it's the same database. All I did is apply clustered Columnstore indexes on the largest tables in the TPCH-derived workload database. Now, one thing out of the gate you'll notice, the report looks the same, but notice in the right-hand corner here the number. That indicates that the database is only taking 8 gigabytes of space, which is a 50% reduction in space in the database because of Columnstore compression. And Columnstore compression, that's one of the greatest advantages of it. It gives you this great compression functionality both in memory and in storage. Let's run the same set of steps we did before to see our behavior here. So I'm going to refresh shipping priority. And if I do that, it's going to come back very fast. I expect that, right? What about the multi-user scenario? Let me kick off another workload like I did before and now try to refresh that data. And you're going to see it does take a few seconds, but it comes back very, very quickly. That's much snappier and crisp than the previous scenario without Columnstore indexes. So let me stop this batch right here. And let's look at that visualization scenario again, where I can just drag and drop elements of data onto my canvas. So I'm going to take the market segment again, going to drop it here. I'm going to go to line item with quantity and drop it. And you'll notice that the results come back instantly. And if I click on these visualizations here as well, the data comes back with a snappier fingers, very snappy. But each of these clicks is doing a full query directly against SQL Server as it did in the previous example, except because of the power of Columnstore. Through column elimination, row group elimination, and batch mode processing, I get super speed against these analytic queries. And so if you're a customer out there worried about using Power BI directly against a SQL Server and you feel like you need to build a model, and in some cases that's a legitimate solution, but direct query against SQL Server, when you combine it with Columnstore in these warehouse scenarios, can be very powerful and give you the comfort that it's possible to have Power BI users running directly against SQL without fear of them getting frustrated for the results or over-consuming resources on your SQL server. And this entire set of demonstrations was run against a SQL Server on Linux because the core database engine capabilities of SQL Server on Linux and Windows are the same. Columnstore is part of that. So when you run Columnstore index technology on SQL on Linux, you get the same functionality that we've built over the years running SQL Server on Windows. I hope you enjoyed this presentation. This entire set of demos are available to you. If you'll just get in your favorite search engine and look for GitHub Bob SQL, you'll find a repo I've got out there where I've got all the Columnstore Power BI desktop files, all the scripts available to you to try this demonstration yourself, install the TPCH-derived database, populate data, and see this amazing results that Columnstore indexes can provide to you. If you're interested in deploying SQL Server on Linux and have not done so yet, I encourage you to go to aka.ms/get-sql-on-linux. Thanks for your time today. I hope you've enjoyed this demonstration.